नमः ओम विष्णु पादाय कृष्ण प्रस्थाय भूतले स्मते वेदांत समनेति नामने नमस्ते सारस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमस्ते तप्त कांचन गौरंगी राध वृंदावनेश्वरी विशभान देवी प्रणमामि दया श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर भाषादि श्री गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम सो on the eve of Janmashtami, we are going to celebrate Janmashtami very soon. On this occasion, from Bhagavat Mahavidyalaya, they have arranged classes by different devotees. Some other, I was asked to give class continuous for 7 days. I have never spoken in any forum for 7 days. First time I am speaking continuously for 7 days. But I am now traveling in tribal area, in forest area. I hope every day I will get internet connection, so that we can smoothly have this Krishna Katha. So, before we hear the pastimes of Krishna, we have to hear the appearance of Krishna. That is the most important pastime. Janma, then karma. Both are important. What most important is to understand the transcendental nature of Krishna's appearance and his activities. Janma karma chame divyam evam jobati tattvata. There are two kinds of consideration for understanding subject matter. One is apata vichar, one general consideration. Another is tattva vichar, to understand subject matter in truth more deeply. So, as Bhagavatam states, mujjanti jatasurayah, the subject matter of the absolute truth, supreme personal to Godhead, builders, not only to ignorant people, common people, intelligent people, that includes great saintly personalities and great demigods also, including Indra, Lord Shiva, Lord Brahma. If this is a subject matter, the subject matter of the absolute truth is built into all these personalities, then who are we to understand? How can we understand it? Actually, to understand Krishna, it is not so easy. Brahma once tried to understand about Bhagavan. So he went to severe austerities for 100 celestial years. After 100 celestial years, then he came to know that he has understood God. That time Narayan appeared in front of Brahma. Narayan asked, oh, Brahma, you have understood me. You have understood about God. Brahma said, yes, my Lord. After 100 celestial years of austerities, I could understand you. Just see, Brahma took 100 years to understand God, celestial years. He has four heads. And we have one head, and how many years we have in our hand? How can we understand God? Not only that, the most important is, after 100 years of celestial years of severe austerity, Brahma understood God. What he understood God? Lord Narayan asked Brahma, oh, what have you understood about me? Then Brahma said, I have understood you. What have you understood about me? Now I have understood that never I can understand you. That is what I have understood. You understand? If Brahma declares understanding absolute truth means it, the conclusion is never we can understand him. And simply surrender. But even if he can never be understood, still scripture says there is a way to understand him. If not completely, whatever it is, there is a way to come understand him. How? সেই সে ঈশ্বর তত্ত্ব বুঝিবারে পারে ঈশ্বরের কৃপালে সহায়ছে যাহার only that person who has received the mercy of ঈশ্বর ভগবান only he can understand about him. Brahma in
what is your school name Gamini? Ayyo school ige vapas kodbeku idna
Brahma in his prayer also saying, Athapita deva padambuja daya prasad lesanu vidhita evai janati tattam bhagavat mahimna nachanna ekapi chiram vichinna. O deva, one who has received the drop of mercy of your lotus feet, padambuja daya, janati tattam bhagavat mahimna. He can understand the glories of Bhagavan. Otherwise, if somebody try life after life, still he cannot understand. So that is about Bhagavan. Very bewildering subject matter. Very bewildering subject matter. And we are trying to understand about his birth and activities, appearance and pastimes. The transcendental nature of his appearance and activity. We can hear it, but to realize it is not so easy. Because if we simply understand and realize it, we become free from material bondage. জন্ম কর্ম চমে দিব্যম এবং জবিত তত্ত্বতঃ তেক্তাদ্যং পুনর্জন্মম নয়তি অর্জুন ওয়ান্স টু লিভ দিস মেটেরিয়াল বডি নেভার উইল টু গেট মেটেরিয়াল বডি সো দ্যাট ইটসেলফ এক্সপ্লেন্স হাউ ডিফিকাল্ট ইট ইজ টু আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড দি ট্রান্সেন্ডেন্টাল নেচার অফ অ্যাপিয়ারেন্স অ্যান্ড past times or activities of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So, okay. The Lord is appearing. We'll discuss about Krishna's appearance, which is very mysterious. As most of followers of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we know we know Krishna's appearance in one way, the whole world knows Krishna's appearance in different way. But we know by following footsteps Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his follower, following Acharyas, for people in the whole world, Krishna's appearance is different. Whole world thinks Krishna appeared as son of Devaki and Vasudeva. But we followers of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we worship Krishna who appeared from the womb of Mother Yashoda, not from the womb of Mother Devaki. That is very specific, important subject matter for the followers of Brahma Madhya Gaudiya Sampradaya. People, how Purna Brahma, Purnatama Bhagavan appeared as Yashodanandana, Nandanandana. That's why Sikhyastakam describes Ainanda Tanuja. The whole world thinks Krishna is the foster son of Nanda Maharaj. He appeared from Devaki Vasudev. The whole world doesn't know that Krishna is not foster son of Nanda Maharaj. He is real son of Nanda Maharaj. Nandatmaja, Ai Nanda Tanuja. Tanuja means who appeared from the body of Nanda Maharaj. His bodily relationship, direct relationship. And there are many, many evidences our Gaudiya Acharyas are explaining to prove that Krishna is son of Nanda Maharaj, and he appeared from the womb of Mother Yashoda. So thus Krishna's appearance is very mysterious to this world, which has been revealed to the people about Krishna's appearance. And we know the basis of the scriptures, how Rama, Vamana, Narasimha had many, many incarnations. Rama, Jimurti, Sakala, Niyamana, Tishta, Nana, Avatar, Aparo, Dhuvana, Sukintu. The Nana, Avatar, many, many incarnations. But Krishna is Swayam Bhagavan. Rama is Bhagavan. Vamana Bhagavan, Narasimha Bhagavan. But Krishna is Swayam Bhagavan. Ekala Ishwara Krishna are sab Bhitya. So thus, Krishna's appearance is much more difficult subject matter to understand. Krishna appearing is much more difficult subject matter. So, Krishna's appearance, this material world is very, very special. We will hear due course of our discussion. During the course of our discussion, we will hear Krishna's appearance pastimes both in Mathura and Gokula. But the important thing is, before we enter into hearing about Krishna's appearance, that he will appear. But we have to understand whether God has any appearance or he has any form or not. Because most of the people in this world, they think God has no form. This concept of God has no form is not limited to Muslim community, not limited to Christian, not limited to Buddhist, Yudhi. This concept of God has no form is very much predominant among the followers of Hindu Dharma, Sanatana Dharma, Vedic Dharma, very predominant. That God has no form, is formless. Nirakar Bhag. There is Nirishwara Bhag. Then there is Ekeshwara Bhag. There is Bahuishwara Bhag. There is Nirakar Bhag. There is Sakar concept of absolute truth. So we are entering a very confusing zone because Veda mostly explains the Nirakar aspects of the absolute truth. The Nirakar aspects of absolute truth, the followers of Jnana Yoga, they try to achieve that. Not much about form, not much about bhakti. So that's a first, briefly we'll discuss whether absolute truth has form or not. So among those, they consider absolute truth has no form, they have two kinds of concepts. One concept is absolute has no form, that's it. Then there is another concept, absolute has no form, but he accepts forms. From nirakar to sakar, this concept is very prominent. Of course, in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna has rejected this kind of concept that Bhagavan appearing from nirakar, formless to form, nirakar to sakar, nirguna to sagun, this kind of concept. And Krishna saying, abhyaktam bhaktim apannam manyatamam abuddhaya param bhava madanatam mamabhutam mam abhyam anuttamam. Abhyaktam bhaktim apannam. For nirakar, I am accepting the sakar form. That is, people have no buddhi. They consider like this. This is answering two points. One is, though they are worshipping demigods, they are alpa buddhi, they are less intelligent. But though they think that I am appearing from nirakar to sakar, they have no buddhi. Abuddhaya, no intelligence. That's why you have to understand on the basis of the scriptures. On the basis of the scripture means on the basis of the Shruti. Of course, Bhagavad Gita has described that he has Janava, that is transcendental. But Manduka Shruti also explains Vidyanta Hidaya Granthi Chindanta Sarvasanshaya. Siyanta chasya karmani tasmin drishte paravare. So Shruti Shastra Upanishad describes that by darshan of that Param Brahma, by seeing that Param Brahma, what will happen? Vidyanta Hidaya Granthi. All the knots inside the karma granthi, inside the heart will be cut up, and also all sarvasanchaya, siddhanta sarvasanchaya, all doubts will be removed, and khyante chasya karmani, this karma will be reduced. When you get darshan of that drishte paravare, if you see that Param Brahma. So this is one thing our Vaishnava Acharyas are putting from Shruti, that God has form. Also, another place, Shruti says, bhakti hi enam darsayati, again darsayati. By bhakti only one can see him. This is from Shruti, darsayati. Also, Brahma Sangita says, प्रेमांजन छुरित भक्ति विलोचनेन संत सदैव हृदयेषु विलोकयन्ति विलोकयन्ति दे कैन सी विद आईज ऑफ भक्ति एंड आल्सो जस्य देवे पराभक्ति तथा देव तथा गुरु प्रकाशन्ते महात्मनः थ्रू दीज वर्सेस दैट वी सी कृष्णा और परम ब्रह्मा He has a form. So we cannot call him Param Brahma. As formless, Param Brahma has form. But Nahang Prakasha Sarvasya Yogamaya Samabhritam. He is not visible to everyone. Yogamaya Samabhritam. He is covered by Yogamaya, Yogamaya Samabhritam. So another name, Bhagavan Param Brahma is known as Aja. Aja means one who has no birth. Aja. That's why some people they challenge Rama and Krishna are cannot be Param Brahma because they took birth. In this material world. Shastra says, Param Brahma is Aja. So how to understand that? So Prabhupada explaining that when Shastra says Param Brahma is Aja, that refers to the spiritual world. The spiritual world, Krishna never took birth. He's eternally there. That's in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna saying, Aja pisan abhyatma bhutanam ishvara pisan prakritin sang adhistaya sambhavami atmamaya. Aja pi, even if I have no birth, but still I appear. But how I appear through my internal potential, that is the transcendental nature. He appears. So in this way, we have to understand different things one after another. First, we understood on the basis of the scripture, na Shruti Shastra, that Param Brahma has form. Then we know the Janma Karma is transcendental. What is transcendental? Transcendental means beyond the modes of material nature. That he does not appear to the modes of material nature. Rather, he appears sambhavami atma mayaya. His internal potential, atma maya, not through mahamaya. These two verses are interesting. In one verse he is saying, Nahang Prakash Sarvasa Yogamaya Samabhita. I am covered by Yogamaya. Then other verse says, Sambhavami Atmamaya. That means, Yogamaya which covers him, that is removed and people can see. It is not like that he had no form. Then he received a form. Rather, he has a form, but which is not manifested to us, which is not revealed to us. That we have to understand. But that Bhagavan, Nitya Abhyaktapi Bhagavan Ichchate Nijasaktitah. Amrite Paramatmanam ka paschatam itam prabhu. That Bhagavan ichchate nijasaktita. He becomes visible by his own internal potency. Though he is nitya abhyakta. He is eternally unmanifested. Param Brahma is eternally unmanifested. but he is becoming visible by his own internal potency. So this is how we have to understand the transcendental nature of appearance of Bhagavan. Srimad Bhagavatam also describes that martya lilaupayikam sva yoga mayabalam darshayata grihitam. That Krishna, to show his, show the power of his yoga maya, he is manifesting this form to show his, so the power of his yoga maya, he is showing this form which is suitable for this martya lila, for these pastimes in this material world. Chaitanya Charitamrita describes yoga maya chit shakti visuddha sattva parinati tar shakti loke dekhaite ei rupa ratana bhakta ganer gudhadhana prakata koila nitya lila hoite. So here Chaitanya Charitamrita describing that prakata koila nitya lila hoite. He has his eternal pastimes. The two kinds of pastimes. One is prakat lila, another is aprakat lila. So in spiritual world, eternally this unmanifested aprakat lila, unmanifested pastimes does not mean pastime is not there. Unmanifested aprakat lila means pastime is going on in spiritual world but not visible to the people of material world. That is aprakat lila. Then there is prakat lila. What is this prakat lila? Prakat lila is when that pastimes become visible to the people of this material world. That is called prakat lila. Prakata koila nitya lila hai. Nitya lila, the eternal pastimes. That form has been manifested. That jewel of its form, that the confidential wealth, gudhadhana, the hidden treasure of his devotees. And that happens because of yoga maya, chit shakti, visuddha sattva parinat, the transformation of visuddha sattva, beyond the modes of material nature, or suddha sattva. So in this way, we have to understand the avirbhav tattva. We discussed first that God has form. Now we discuss what his appearance means, what Krishna's birth means. Prakritiṃ sva adhiṣṭhāya, sva prakriti, his own internal energy, sambhavāmi atmamāya. So that is very special. That makes his activities and his birth Divya, janma karma cha, me divyam. That's why Shastra says, in Purusha Badhani Upanishad, it has been described, eka deva nitya lilanurukta bhakta vyapti hidyantaratma. That how, that one, undual, without second, that is transcendental form manifesting to his devotees through different pastimes. For everybody, it may not be possible, but for devotees, it is manifested. The Lord, he appears in two different ways. I told you about the pastimes of the Lord, manifested past prakat lila, aprakat lila. Because we are discussing about appearance, So we should know this subject also. Lord appears in two different ways. Called Sadwaraka and Adwaraka. Sadwaraka means when Lord appears without the help of father and mother. Just like he appeared at Matsyavatar. That is the fish incarnation. Fish incarnation, tortoise incarnation, boar incarnation, Kurma Rupa. Up to Narasingha Rupa, Lord appeared without father and mother. He appeared from the pillar, Narasingha Bhagavata. Matsya appeared from the water of hand of the king. So like this, Varahadeva appeared from the nose of Brahma. So there is no example of that he's appearing through father and mother. But we see Vamanadev appeared father, mother, Parshuram appeared father, mother, then Ramachandra, Balaram, Krishna, they're all appeared through father, mother. When there's no father, mother, that is Adwara. When Lord appears with the help of father, mother, from the womb of mother, that is the Sadwara. So people may not understand how Bhagavan can appear for the womb of a lady. That we'll discuss also. When you discuss about parents of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, what is this? What is made up of? What is the mother of the Supreme? Who can become mother of Supreme Personality of Godhead? Can anybody become father, mother of Supreme Personality of Godhead just by doing some tapasya, some good karma? No. So there are more to understand about that also. So up to now, I describe.
Janal ke yenundi learning ka podgantlor kundi mundra. Bajun sa spongkone podk late ay potna ni mura jeldi peti nar yoda narkin ninka yenundi narke.
So I described that past that God has formed, which will be able to appear. Then second, about his appearance. What does this mean, appearance? Then third is, I'll describe to you that when God appears in this material world, okay, through this discussion, we'll hear about what appearance means, when he appears, why he appears, how he appears, where he appears. Okay. Before hearing the appearance pastimes of Lord Krishna, all the subject matter are not known properly, so people will misunderstand. Now our point of discussion is, when Krishna appears in this material world, I'll ask when. In Sanskrit, kada. Kada means when. In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna saying jada, jada, jadahi. Kada, kada, Krishna, Bhagavan coming, na jada, jadahi. Whenever. Dharmasa glanir bhavati bharata abhyuthanam adharmasa tadatmanam sujami. So Krishna said, I manifest when there is glani of dharma decline, dharma religious principle decline, and adharma, irreligious things arising, that time Bhagavan comes. But when is that time? When is that time? He is saying next verse, Sambhavami Yuge Yuge. Every yuga I am coming. Actually, Lord is coming in so many different ways, always from so many. There is Guna Avatar, Manantara Avatar, Yuga Avatar, so many avatars. But Krishna, every yuga, once in every yuga I am coming. But Krishna is saying every yuga I am coming, but that is not true. We know Krishna is not coming every yuga. He did not come in Satya Yuga, Tritya Yuga, he came only in Dwapar Yuga. He is not coming in every yuga. But he is saying, I come in every yuga. But he does not come personally every yuga, his incarnations comes. Yuga avatars, they come every yuga. But we, all of you know, from Chaitanya Charitamrita, there is a description that how Krishna comes in once in one day of Brahma. And that description is given by Krishna Sabras Goswami, that when Krishna comes, not every yuga, as he has told in Bhagavad Gita, Sambhavami Yuga Yuga, he comes once in one day of Brahma, because he is Swayam Bhagavan, Purna Bhagavan. Purna Bhagavan Krishna, Brajendra Kumar, son of Nanda Maharaj, Purna Bhagavan. Lord Acharya is describing Krishna in Dwaraka, he is Purna. In Mathura, he is Purna Tara, complete, more complete. But in Vrindavan, most complete. Mathura, Dwaraka, Vrindavan, same Krishna, same Tattva, but different rasa and different bhava. Difference in Aishwarya and Madhurya. That Bhagavan, Goloka Brajare Saha Nitya Vihar, is having his sweet pastimes eternally in Goloka Vrindavan. ब्रह्मार एक दिने तिहो एक बार अवतीर्ण हया करे न प्रकट विहार वंस इन वन डे ऑफ ब्रह्मा ही डिसेंड्स ही कम्स फ्रॉम गोलोक वृंदावन एंड प्रकट विहार मैनिफेस्टेड पास्ट टाइम्स ही एग्जिबिट्स इज मैनिफेस्टेड पास्ट टाइम्स सो व्हाट इज वन डे ऑफ ब्रह्मा सत्य त्रता द्वापर कलि चारि युग जानी सही चारि युग दिव्य एक युग मानी सत्य त्रता द्वापर कलि फोर युगस फोर युगस टुगेदर कॉल वन दिव्य युग और चतुर्युग और इंग्लिश दे कॉल युग साइकिल फोर युग वन दिव्य युग लाइक दिस एकहत्तर चतुर्युग एक मन्वंतर 71 Chaturyuga makes one manvantar, and there are 14 manu, they rule in one day of Brahma. 14 manvantar Brahma divasa pita. In one day of Brahma, 14 manu ruling. Vaivasvata manu, the 14 manu, Swayambhava manu, Sorichisa manu, Chakusa manu, Raivatamano, like this, and Vaivasvatamano, then another, the seventh mano, Vaivasvatamanantara. This mano name is Shraddha Deva, Shraddha Deva. And Vaivasvatanama is Saptama Manantara. Seventh Manantara is Vaivasvatamanantara. And every Manantara has 71 Chaturyuga Dibhyajuga. And out of 71, 27 Chaturyuga already passed. Satais Chaturyuga Gela Tahara Anta ವೈವಸ್ವತ ನಾಮೈ ಸಪ್ತಮ ಮನ್ವಂತ ಸತಾಯಿಸ್ ಚತುರ್ಯುಗ ಗೆಲೆ ತಹಾರ ಅಂತ ದೆನ್ ವೈವಸ್ವತ ಮನ್ವಂತ 27 ಚತುರ್ಯುಗ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಪಾಸ್ 28 ಚತುರ್ಯುಗ ಅಷ್ಟವಿಂಶ ಚತುರ್ಯುಗೆ 28 ಚತುರ್ಯುಗ ದ್ವಾಪರ ಶೇಷ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ್ವಾಪರ ಯುಗ ಪ್ರಜರ ಸಹಿತ ಕೃಷ್ಣರ ಪ್ರಕಾಶ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಚುಯಲ್ ಅಪರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಹಿ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕಮ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಹಿ ಕಮ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಚುಯಲ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಪ್ರಭು ಜೀವೆ ದಯಾ ಕರಿ ಸಪಾರ್ಶ್ವದ ಶ್ರೀಧಾಮ ಸಹ ಅವತರ ವೆನ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಭಗವಾನ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಹಿ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಚುಯಲ್ ಅವತ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಟ್ ಸಪಾರ್ಶ್ವದ ಶ್ರೀಧಾಮ ಸೊ ಭಗವಾನ್ ಕೇಮ್ ದ್ವಾಪರ ಶೇಷ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ್ವಾಪರ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಎಂಡ್ 125 years Krishna had manifested past time on this earthly planet. Shastra has described pancha vinshati varshancha satta varshadhikam mune tishtan jagama golokam prithivinsha puratana. Param Purusha Bhagavan tishtan he stayed in this material world pancha vishanti varsha ta satta varsha satta pancha means 125 years then jagama golokam then he left the day Krishna left this material world that is Friday Krishna appeared on Wednesday Krishna's appearance then Wednesday then he left body I mean he went back to the spiritual world that was Friday and the day Krishna left this earthly planet the same day Kali entered Vishnu Chakravarti has mentioned माघे माघ श्री तेसु तेसु तद अंतर्धानम कलि प्रवेशम दैट मस्ट बी मंथ ऑफ माघ समथिंग लाइक दैट तेसु तेसु तद अंतर्धानम व्हेन कृष्णा मंथ ऑफ माघ दैट फ्राइडे दैट ही लेफ्ट दिस मटेरियल वर्ल्ड तेसु तेसु तद अंतर्धानम कलि प्रवेशम देन कलि युग that entered into this material world. So like this, Krishna, he appears once in one day of Brahma. In one day of Brahma, there are 14 Manu ruling. On seventh Manu's ruling period, in each Manu, 71 Chaturyuga, 28 Chaturyuga period, Dwapara Yuga, towards the end of Dwapara Yuga, Krishna appeared. There's a calculation been given when Krishna appeared. So when I joined ISKCON, I was hearing Krishna appeared 5,000 years ago. So I have joined ISKCON 45 years ago. And today also same thing are hearing. Krishna appeared 5,000 years ago. How is it possible? Not 5,001, 5,002. Always you are talking Krishna appeared 5,000 years ago. But our acharyas have given a calculation by which we can understand exact how many years. Just like we know exact how many years, 523 or 24, something like that, we say Gaurav. Same way Krishna's appearance also. So we'll do a little calculation on that now. before I end the class for today. So, according to astrology, the Kali Yuga appeared 3101 years before Christ. Christabda. So BC, 3101 BC. So 3101 BC, now it is 2021. So if you add it, it's coming 5122. So Kali Yuga up to now is 5,122 years out of 432,000 years. Kali Yuga has passed only 5,122 years. Okay, so from that we can calculate how many years Krishna's birthday. So the day Krishna left body, same day Kali entered. And we have to add to this Krishna's lifespan manifested pastime, and this earthly planet was 125. So we have to add 125. I have heard Krishna had pastimes in Vrindavan for 11 years, 6 months, in Mathura, 13 years, 6 months. In Dwaraka, 100 years. In this way, he had 125 years manifested pastimes. So if we add 125 years to 5,122, then it will come 5,247 years. Something like this. 1 year exactly has to be calculated. So that we'll be celebrating 5,247th birth anniversary, or maybe exactly calculate 8th year's birth anniversary. So in our invitation card, we should mention this. Every temple should mention this. When the calculation is there, exactly how many years before Krishna gave Bhagavad Gita Gyan, and Krishna exactly how many years, it will be nice if ISKCON promotes in the invitation card that this year is 5,247th appearance and anniversary or birth anniversary of Supreme Personality of Godhead. So in this session, I discussed 3 different topics that to understand about appearance, has to have to understand whether he has any appearance or not. He has any form or not. So we discussed that topic. Then second topic is, what does his appearance means? What abhirbhava means? That subject matter we discussed. Then third topic we discussed today, that when he appears. So like this, today I'm going to close my discussion here. So tomorrow we'll discuss why he appears. And little continuation of when he appears, we'll continue on that subject matter, the exact muhurta. That description also given in the scriptures written by Gunaraj Khan, Sri Krishna Vijay, there is one book, Sri Krishna Vijay. Gunaraj Khan, one of the associates of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, has described the exact calculation, muhurta, everything about Krishna's appearance. Okay. So tomorrow we'll continue discussing, provided, as I told you, I'm in jungle. So I don't get always internet. If I get internet connection, then only I will appear. I don't know otherwise what will happen. If I come on Zoom, then we'll discuss why Krishna appears. This is very confidential, mysterious question. And why Krishna appears? And also, we'll discuss about his father, mother, different subject matters before we exactly hear about the appearance pastimes of Supreme Personality of Godhead. Thank you so much. Jai Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Jai Sri Krishna Bhagavan ki jai. Jai Gaur Chaitanya Prabhu Anande Hari Hari Bol.